हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर अरविंद कुमार शर्मा, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ लाइब्रेरी इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस, महारानी लक्ष्मीबाई, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज ऑफ एक्सीलेंस, ग्वालियर, मध्य प्रदेश। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन मॉड्यूल एजेंसीज इन द प्रमोशन ऑफ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज फ्रॉम पेपर पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज। The objectives: after studying this module, you will be able to understand the following. Agencies involved in the promotion and development of public libraries. To understand the contribution of government, non-government, corporate houses, and individuals in the establishment and promotion of public libraries in India, and discuss the recommendations of National Knowledge Commission regarding libraries. Public library can be considered as the common man's learning center. It is a great informal medium for educating the masses. Education for all is an ultimate goal of any democratic nation, but to achieve this is a difficult challenge for government as well as other agencies. Government of India has enacted Right to Education and Right to Information Acts to strengthen the cause. These acts facilitate a common man to take the equal benefit of all resources. This process can be further strengthened by promoting public library system in the society. As you are aware, India is a vast federal and multifaceted country where people reside in distant and scattered places. So it is very difficult to reach every village or person to provide an effective library services. So gigantic efforts are needed. Indeed, apart from government agencies, other various agencies are also playing a significant role in the establishment, development, and promotion of public library system in India. All these agencies have contributed a lot in the promotion of public library system in India. These agencies can be grouped into the following: government and autonomous bodies, non-governmental organizations, NGOs and institutions, corporate houses, and individuals. Government and autonomous agencies. Various efforts have been made by central government, state governments, and government financially supported agencies for the establishment, development, and promotion of public library system in India. Various ministries, such as Ministry of Human Resource and Development, Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Rural Development, Ministry of Communication and Technology, Ministry of Social Welfare, etc., and government supported institutions are working for the dissemination of in knowledge and information in urban as well as rural areas of India. State ministries are also emphasizing to promote literacy and illiteracy among the people of their region. Ministries and departments of Government of India and autonomous agencies. Information and knowledge are the basic ingredients for any kind of developmental activity. Open, and equal access to information can lead to the inclusive development. Gaps between knowledge of haves and have-nots can be bridged by providing public library facility to the public. Various ministries of Government of India, such as Ministry of Rural Development, Ministry of Information Communication and Technology, Ministry of Panchayati Raj, Ministry of Culture, etc., are playing a vital role in the establishment and promotion of public library system in India. They have come out with various schemes to strengthen the public library system in India. Panchayati Raj Institutions. Panchayati Raj Institutions, PRIs, are engaged in the socio-economic development of the people of rural India. Panchayati Raj is a system of self-governance at district, janpad, and gram level in India. It strengthens the inclusive and sustainable development of the people by promoting local and micro-level planning to boost the socio-economic developmental process at rural level, and also takes initiatives to exploit and utilize the locally available various resources. In India, Constitutional 73rd Amendment Act came into force on April 24, 1993. This act provides constitutional status to the three-tier Panchayati Raj system in India. All Indian states have adopted this Panchayati Raj system. With the introduction of this Panchayati Raj system, several schemes have been introduced for educational and informational advancement of the people. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, SSA. This Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, means education for all, is a global mission. Educating all is a global challenge. And Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan is the flagship program and unique scheme of Government of India with the collaboration of state governments and other agencies to provide education for all and promote literacy through the decentralization of resources and active participation of local people. It was launched in 2001. Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and Madhya Pradesh. A unique scheme known as Padhna Badhana Sangh has been designed in Madhya Pradesh for adult education. Under the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, the Government of Madhya Pradesh has designed a network of rural libraries in remote rural areas of Madhya Pradesh. In this scheme, there is a provision of establishing a library in each village to keep the new literates in the mainstream of education and learning. Under this scheme, since 26 January 2003, rural libraries were established. These libraries were established in premises of schools, Anganwadi Kendras, and Gram Swaraj Bhavan. The provision of initial establishment expenses amounting to ₹12,500 per library was made. Under this scheme, in the district of Datia, Gwalior, and Shivpuri, as many as 572 604 and 1300 rural libraries were established respectively. Raja Ramon Rai Library Foundation. Raja Ramon Rai Library Foundation was established in May 1972 by the Department of Culture, Government of India. Raja Ramon Rai Library Foundation is registered under the West Bengal Society's Registration Act 1961. This foundation is devoted to public library development in India. It is working in close and active cooperation with the state governments and union territory administrations. The foundation has taken an initiative to develop district youth resource centers, DYRCs, in collaboration with Nehru Yuvak Kendra Sangathan. There are various schemes such as matching. Under this, assistance is given to following purposes: assistance towards building of adequate stock of books and reading materials, assistance towards development of rural book deposit centers and mobile library services. Next, assistance towards organization of seminars, workshops, training courses, book exhibitions, and library awareness programs. Assistance towards purchase of storage materials, reading room furniture, and library equipment. Assistance to public libraries towards increasing accommodation. Assistance to public libraries to acquire computer with accessories. Raja Ramon Rai Library also provides non-matching grants, and under this scheme, assistance is given to following purposes: assistance towards building up adequate stock of books through central selection, assistance to voluntary organizations, NGOs, providing public library services, assistance to children's libraries, assistance to public libraries towards celebration of 15th, 16th, 75, 100s, and 125 and 150 years and the like, assistance towards organization of seminar, conference by professional organizations, local bodies, NGOs engaged in public library development and development of library services, assistance towards collection of compilation of library statistics through official and non-official agencies, assistance to centrally sponsored libraries, assistance towards establishment of Raja Ramon Rai Library Foundation Children Corner, National Mission on Libraries, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. National Mission on Libraries, also known as NML, has been set up by the Government of India by Gazette notification dated 14th May 2012. Raja Ramon Rai Library Foundation is the nodal agency for this mission. Various working groups have been set up under the mission to prepare future plans. In the first meeting of National Mission on Libraries, various decisions were taken to promote library system in India. There is a plan to link nearly 9,000 libraries across the country, and this project will cost ₹1,000 crore. Community Information Centers, CICs. Ministry of Information and Broadcasting Government of India launched a project in April 2000 to establish community information centers in all blocks of northeastern region such as Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Sikkim and Tripura. The purpose of establishing these community information centers was to extend to reach of modern information communication technologies to remote areas of these states. Community information centers have been set up in all 487 blocks of northeastern states. State governments and union territories to have planned and launched various schemes to establish and promote public library system in their areas. Various state ministries such as Ministry of Social Welfare, Ministry of Rural Development, Ministry of Panchayati Raj, Ministry of Education and Ministry of Culture are providing financial assistance through various schemes for the development of public libraries. Presently, 19 states have enacted Public Library Acts in India. Most of the states and union territories have public library system. These public libraries are getting funds from their state governments and local authorities. For example, there are 120 public libraries in Goa, and these libraries are controlled by State Central Library. There are 19 non-government public libraries which are under the control of Directorate of Arts and Culture, Government of Goa. There are 226 such public libraries in Manipur. Community Library and Information Center, CLIC project. Government of West Bengal has taken up a project to set up nearly 1,500 community library and information centers in phases in the villages which lack public library facility. More than 100 community library and information centers have been set up, and these CLICs are being looked after by part-time community library organizers, CLO. These community library and information centers provide library services and also fulfill the information needs of rural people. Non-governmental organizations, NGOs and institutions. In India, non-governmental organizations are playing an important role in socio-economic development of people as well as in providing knowledge and information to the masses. Non-government organizations, NGOs, are working for the poor people, and it is a well-established fact that people must be equipped with the weapon of information. And this astra weapon protects from exploitation and opens new opportunities. They also pave the path of inclusive and sustainable development of the people. NGOs and various institutions have contributed a lot in the establishment and development of information centers and libraries in various regions of the country. Religious institutions. In India, various religious institutions run public libraries and reading rooms for spreading knowledge or religious information among the followers and common men. These libraries are financially supported and managed by the respective organizations from local bodies. It is a tradition in religious places to maintain a small collection of religious and other books to cater the information needs of the pupils. These libraries are having good collection of all types of reading material and serving the people in right spirit. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation established in 1991 and has been working for socio-economic development of the people. Rajiv Gandhi Foundation has established 1,344 rural libraries and 100 urban libraries in 22 states. Ranganathan Society for Social Welfare and Library Development, BIMTEC. Ranganathan Society for Social Welfare and Library Development, Birla Institute of Management Technology, is a non-government organization constituted in 2009. This NGO has taken several initiatives towards establishing libraries in rural areas and jails in Uttar Pradesh. Sanmati Pustakalay Trust. Sanmati Pustakalay Trust, Jaipur, has been organizing Motilal Memorial Lecture in various places of Rajasthan. Trust also runs a public library and facilitates Master Motilal Sanghi Best Librarian Award on the anniversary of Master Motilal Ji. This national level award was started in 2008. Trust also brought out a Master Motilal Sri Sanmati Pustakalay souvenir in 1972. Joint Assistance Center, India. It is a non-voluntary group and has established libraries in Ahmednagar villages, district Kheri of UP. Rural Library Foundation. It is a voluntary organization and runs 28 libraries in Warangal, Karimnagar and Medak district of Andhra Pradesh. Corporate houses. Corporate houses have also paid attention to their social responsibility. They have done a great job to empower the people with information and knowledge. They have funded various projects to provide information to urban as well as rural areas of India. Indian corporate houses are now more engaged in corporate social responsibility, CSR, in the form of charity or philanthropy. Big houses are supporting social institutions such as public libraries, and public libraries are transforming the people's life by providing right information to the right user at the right time. Some corporate initiatives are as follows. Infosys Foundation. Infosys Foundation has donated 10,200 set of books under the library for every rural school. Project has set up more than 10,150 libraries in government schools. It also donated computers to schools. Sri Ratan Tata Trust and Navaj Bhai Ratan Tata Trust. Sri Ratan Tata Trust was established in 1919 and Navaj Bhai Ratan Tata Trust was formed in 1974. Both trusts are working in education, health and other areas and helping the needy people in various ways and also helped in the establishment of public libraries in India. Azim Premji Foundation. This Azimji Premji Foundation was founded in 2001 by business tycoon and philanthropist Azim हाशिम प्रेम जी। फाउंडेशन हैज़ एस्टेब्लिश्ड लाइब्रेरीज इन डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड दीज लाइब्रेरीज आर ओपन टू स्टूडेंट्स, स्कॉलर्स, टीचर्स एंड द कम्युनिटी। लाइब्रेरीज हैव बुक्स, जर्नल्स, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डाटाबेसेस एंड ओपन एक्सेस रिसोर्सेस एंड दिस लाइब्रेरीज कैन बी सर्च्ड ऑन अजीम प्रेमजी फाउंडेशन .org/library। DLF फाउंडेशन। DLF फाउंडेशन हैज़ इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द DLF रूरल मोबाइल लाइब्रेरीज इन रूरल एरियाज ऑफ हरियाणा। इट इज़ प्रमोटिंग रीडिंग हैबिट्स इन ऑल एज ग्रुप ऑफ रूरल पॉपुलेशन। इंडिविजुअल्स, सम इंडिविजुअल्स हैव आल्सो प्लेड अ पिवोटल रोल इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज इन इंडिया। देयर कंट्रीब्यूशन कैन बी रिमेंबर्ड एज अ माइल स्टोन इन द प्रमोशन ऑफ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज इन इंडिया। द नोटेबल पर्सन्स आर एज फॉलोज, मोती भाई अमीन, ही पॉपुलराइज्ड लाइब्रेरीज इन गुजराती स्पीकिंग एरियाज। महाराजा सयाजीराव गायकवाड़ ऑफ बरोडा, ही प्रमोटेड पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी सिस्टम इन हिज स्टेट एंड ही एस्टेब्लिश्ड अ फुल फ्लेज्ड सिस्टम ऑफ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज इंक्लूडिंग अ सेंट्रल लाइब्रेरी एंड नियरली 800 ब्रांच लाइब्रेरीज एंड मोबाइल लाइब्रेरीज इन द स्टेट। विलियम ए बॉर्डन वॉज इंगेज्ड बाई महाराजा ऑफ बरोडा टू ऑर्गेनाइज पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी सिस्टम इन द स्टेट। ही ट्रेंड इंडियंस अबाउट टूल्स एंड टेक्निक्स ऑफ लाइब्रेरी साइंस। न्यूटन मोहन दत्त वॉज क्यूरेटर ऑफ लाइब्रेरीज इन 1921 एंड गेव गाइडेंस टू द लाइब्रेरी मूवमेंट इन बरोडा। सर आई वी रमैया, ही कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन लाइब्रेरी मूवमेंट इन आंध्र प्रदेश। मुनीन्द्र देव राय महाशय वॉज एसोसिएटेड विद लाइब्रेरी मूवमेंट इन बंगाल। मास्टर मोतीलाल सांगी वॉज ए टीचर एंड एस्टेब्लिश्ड अ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी नेम्ड श्री सम्मति पुस्तकालय इन जयपुर इन 1920 एंड ही कंट्रीब्यूटेड पर्सनली इन द प्रमोशन ऑफ फ्री पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी सर्विसेज टू द पीपल। संतराम भाटिया, संतराम भाटिया प्रमोटेड पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी सर्विसेज इन पंजाब। डॉक्टर एस आर रंगनाथन हैज़ कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज स्पेशली इन ड्राफ्टिंग पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी बिल्स फॉर इंडियन स्टेट्स। सर आई वी रमैया, ही कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन लाइब्रेरी मूवमेंट इन आंध्र प्रदेश। मुनीन्द्र देव राय महाशय वॉज एसोसिएटेड विद लाइब्रेरी मूवमेंट इन बंगाल। मास्टर मोतीलाल सांघी वॉज ए टीचर एंड एस्टेब्लिश्ड अ पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी नेम्ड श्री सन्मति पुस्तकालय इन जयपुर इन 1920। ही कंट्रीब्यूटेड पर्सनली इन द प्रमोशन ऑफ फ्री पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी सर्विसेज टू द पीपल। नेशनल नॉलेज कमीशन एंड पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज। एज यू आर अवेयर, नेशनल नॉलेज कमीशन NKC वॉज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड ऑन 13 June 2005 बाई द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया अंडर द चेयरमैनशिप ऑफ सैम पित्रोदा। कमीशन सबमिटेड इट्स रिपोर्ट इन December 2006। कमीशन हैज़ मेड रिकमेंडेशंस ऑन लाइब्रेरीज इंक्लूडिंग पब्लिक लाइब्रेरीज एंड मेजर रिकमेंडेशंस आर सेटअप अ नेशनल मिशन ऑन लाइब्रेरीज, प्रिपेयर अ नेशनल सेंसस ऑन ऑल लाइब्रेरीज, रिवैम्प लाइब्रेरी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस एजुकेशन ट्रेनिंग एंड रिसर्च फैसिलिटीज, रीअसेस स्टाफिंग ऑफ लाइब्रेरीज। set up a central library fund, modernize library management, encourage greater community participation in library management, promoting information communication technologies application in all libraries, facilitate donation and maintenance of private collections, encourage public-private partnership in development of library and information services. Further, commission said networking of all public libraries should be undertaken in a phased manner. There are approximately 54,000 public libraries in existence in India. Phase 1, 1,000 of these libraries to be networked in phase 1 as a pilot project by Delnet, Developing Library Network, and InfibNet, Information and Library Network, each covering about 500 libraries in 12 to 18 months. Phase 2, based on experience of phase 1, up to 10,000 libraries to be covered in 1 year. In phase 3, the remaining libraries may be networked in the third and final phase in 3 years. So NKC, National Knowledge Commission, has made recommendations on structural reforms in public library system in India. If these recommendations are followed in the right direction, then the scenario of public libraries will be changed. National Mission on Libraries, NML, has been set up by the Government of India under the NKC's recommendations. So students, let us conclude this module. In this module, various agencies engaged in the promotion and development of public libraries have been discussed, which are directly or indirectly associated with the promotion of public library cause. As you are aware, public libraries have received support from a variety of sections of society. In India, central government, state government, non-government organizations, corporate houses, and individuals have been playing a vital role in the promotion of public libraries in India. All the stakeholders, including central, state governments, non-government organizations, institutions, organizations, corporate houses, and philanthropists, and library and information professionals have to work in a coordinate way. More and more people will be covered and served by the libraries. Education for all is the ultimate aim to be achieved in near future. Thank you.